is I think there's so many people, often young people, who look to the future and people are concerned, they're pessimistic, they feel that things are just getting worse and worse. This technology is what should give people hope.
Hi, I'm Christoph, co-founder and co-CEO of Climeworks.
And I'm Brad Smith, vice chair and president at Microsoft. And today, I want to learn about what you're doing with direct air capture.
Well, we have too much CO2 in the atmosphere already, and it's getting even more. So we are working on machines that filter CO2 from the air. We're burning fossil fuels, dumping it in the atmosphere, but we're not taking care of it.
So in simple terms, right now humanity is emitting perhaps 50, 52 billion tons of CO2 a year. We know we have to get that down to say 15 or 12 by 2050, but then if we're going to get to a net zero world, we have to remove the rest. And this is one of the most promising technologies in many ways.
Exactly. We'll in 30 years from now, we'll be heading to a world where we'll be able to reduce 90% of the CO2 that we're currently emitting. And 10% will be remaining, those 10, 15 gigatons, so-called hard-to-abate or unavoidable emissions through, for example, agriculture or hard-to-abate industries like concrete making, steel, aluminum making. And for those things, it'll be important that there's a means of extracting CO2 from the air.
Well, for us at Microsoft, this has been important for a couple of reasons. First, it's helping us achieve our own climate pledges. We've said we'll be carbon negative by 2030. That means we will actually be removing from the atmosphere more carbon than we emit. We have to bring our emissions down, but we need new technologies like what Climeworks is creating to make good and deliver on our pledge.
Many people don't understand. They still ask, hey, should I do this or should I do this? The answer is you have to do both, right? So I always say you're only allowed to use and as a connector between climate mitigation strategies and not or. Today, as of 2022, there is scientific consensus looking at the latest IPCC report that went out in April this year. It confirms that we need to extract very large quantities of CO2 from the atmosphere to achieve climate targets. The thing is that in 2050, we have to be at a gigaton. To put that in numbers, we are currently operating on thousands of tons of carbon removal capacity per year. We are very confident that we'll be operating at megaton capacity by end of this decade, 2030. From megaton capacity to billion ton capacity, it's a scale up factor of 1,000 in 20 years. And this is something which is clearly ambitious, but something that's doable. That's what renewables did in the last 20 years. Between 2000 and 2020, wind and solar have been growing by 1,000x. How did they scale? Through government programs. They had very strong feed-in tariff programs at the beginning of the 2000s. And this is exactly what we need to do. We need to start today through private actions like the one of Microsoft.
I think to me, at bottom, what is so important here is I think there's so many people, often young people, who look to the future and people are concerned, they're pessimistic, they feel that things are just getting worse and worse. This technology is what should give people hope, because what you are inventing is going to take carbon out of the atmosphere and put it deep underground, and not just correct, but reverse 3 centuries of carbon emissions. We live in a time when some great people are figuring out how to go to Mars, but what you're doing is saving humanity's future on planet Earth.